The Ride Home Rants podcast is brought to you by Reaper Apparel Company. Reaper Apparel offers a casual line of superb fit, finish, and comfort. We design for those who refuse to die slowly and choose to live untamed. For those who aren't afraid to face the dark, for the ones that thrive in it, and for those who can appreciate life through a grim lens. That's Reaper Apparel Company. Go to the link in the description of this episode. Use the promo code MikeBono and get 10% off. Also, the Ride Home Rants podcast is brought to you by my own personal merch store, the Stupid Should Hurt merch store. I have hats, I have t-shirts, hoodies, coffee mugs, water bottles, notebooks, you name it, I've got it. The description and the link for that will be in the description of this episode. Also, right now, if you use the promo code WELCOME, I will give you 5% off of your first purchase. That's the Stupid Should Hurt merch store. Also, the Ride Home Rants podcast is brought to you by Tactical Brotherhood. All American made apparel, which helps support the Second Amendment. You can also find all this in the description of this episode with the link, Tactical Brotherhood. Part of every proceed does go to helping veterans, as it is a very good cause. All American-made products made right here in Minnesota. Go and check them out. Use the promo code PATRIOT15 to get 15% off your purchase. Now, let's start the show. Welcome, everybody, to another episode of the Ride Home Rants podcast. This is, as always, your host, Mike Bono. I have a great guest for us today. He comes all the way to us from Notre Dame College. He is the assistant baseball coach. Kyle Espineli joins the show. Kyle, thanks for joining, man.
Yeah, absolutely. I appreciate you having me. I'm excited. Hey. So, it's the first podcast for me, so you know I'm ready to get after it. It's going to be great.
Absolutely, man. Yeah, no worries. We're going to keep this light and fun here. But first and foremost, you know, where did you grow up and where are you from originally? Tell all the listeners out there where you're from.
Yeah, so I'm actually from Canada, so a little bit out of the way from here.
A little bit out of the way from Ohio.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so I grew up in Toronto my whole life. I actually grew up in a city called Pickering, so it's just like the outskirts of it. So I grew up there my whole life, and then once I got over here to Ohio, that's when I kind of moved a little bit closer to the city. So it's just right outside of Toronto, about 45 minutes away. So I've been in Ohio for about 6 years now.
Okay. So, what are some things Americans don't know about, Canada, what people like to do up there besides hockey? I mean, that's a given.
I mean, no, that's pretty much it, you know, for the most part. I guess that's why I'm over here living the American dream, you know? I'm a big baseball guy, as you know, so, you know, the only way for me to make it happen and go be in the position that I am today was just to come here to the U.S. But now it's crazy because the game of baseball has grown so much in Canada. So it's kind of like, you know, I kind of wish the opportunities that happened over there in Canada was happening when I was there. But, you know, it is what it is. And, you know, I'm just blessed to be here in the position I'm in, you know.
Absolutely. So you played baseball in high school, correct?
Yes. So, it's funny because over there in Canada, high school sports aren't as serious unless it's like hockey, I guess a little bit of football. It's basically hockey and soccer. Those are the two biggest ones. But honestly, the only reason why I joined the team was one, you know, to get extra reps in, and two was just to get out of class. That's basically how it is over there. I mean, you know, I had my baseball coach for a couple of years with my business teacher, and I think it went to like my arts teacher. I don't know, something like that. But, you know, it's just for us to get extra reps in and stuff like that and just have a good time. But, you know, it's not as serious as they take it over here in the U.S. So I'm still trying to get adapted to all the little things as far as, like, you know, recruiting and, like, you know, just seeing how high school ball works over here compared to travel ball and stuff like that. So it's just little things like that that's different.
Yeah. So you mentioned recruiting. What was the recruiting process like for you coming out of high school for baseball? In Canada.
Yeah. So, the biggest thing was, so travel ball over there is a big thing for us. So, when you join a travel, I was on a team called the Ontario Cardinals. So when you join a travel ball organization, it's more exposure into the U.S. So basically, for majority of us, the kids on my team, we all, went on to play in the U.S. but it's basically all the tournaments that we play besides one, and that's like playoffs. They're all in the U.S. So every weekend in like the summer, I'd be in like Ohio, Michigan, Chicago, all that good stuff. So I had a pretty good feel of the U.S. because I was there literally every single weekend for like 2 months straight. But besides that, though, that's kind of how I got recruited, and just sending a whole lot of emails and just having my head coach, who was the player development, the recruiting coordinator at the time. Sorry. But he would basically just send me a whole bunch of schools that I was interested in. And then from there, I would just kind of come in contact with a whole bunch of coaches. So it was pretty much relatively the same thing as it was. But obviously, there are just some new things that I had to overcome and like kind of understand how the process worked. Pretty much the same.
Okay. Yeah. So, you know, when people think of Canada sports, you know, we all know hockey's king, and we know the Raptors in basketball, now the Blue Jays in baseball. Everyone knows the Canadian Football League is baseball, you know, getting more popular in schools, and, you know, does it make it hard to get recruited with all those other sports in Canada kind of overshadowing baseball, it seems, a little bit?
Yeah, so, you know, like I mentioned before, the game has definitely, you know, grown a lot in Canada. So there's just, you familiar with Robbie Alomar?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, so he played for the Jays, I don't even know, I guess somewhere in the 90s. Give or take. But, you know, since he, I'm pretty sure that was the last team he played for. Don't quote me on that, but he basically has a tournament over there now. It's called Tournament 12. And it's basically, that's kind of how it all started and how the game kind of grew a little bit. So it's just them getting exposure for a bunch of kids in Canada to kind of grow a little bit. So from there, I feel like the following year, that's when I moved to the U.S. That's when I finally committed to a school. But now there's things called Prep Baseball Report, and they kind of evolved over into the Canadian side. Okay. So in a bunch of all the, I guess, the teams over there, they're now travel ball organizations. So, like, again, the game's really growing, and they're all the exposure over here. They kind of all head over to the U.S. now. So, again, a lot of these teams, they make it in a way for them to get recruited. So, which kind of makes it a little bit easier. But, you know, since the game has grown a lot, since it was a Josh Naylor, since he made it over there, we're actually the same age. So there was 1 year, actually a handful of years where we played against each other in some championship games. So like my team would always face his team. But like I know his class, the team that he was on, a bunch of them went on to play in the U.S. and stuff like that. So it's basically, that's pretty much it. Basically, all their groups, right, they've kind of all evolved and whatnot, which makes the game just grow more and more. And even I worked in a PBR event over in BC, and over there, since it's pretty close to the U.S., that game has grown. That side of Canada has grown a lot, too, over the years. So
that's awesome. So, I mean, you mentioned you landed at a college. I mean, you ultimately land at Notre Dame College for academics and athletics, you know, so where did you come from, and what made you want to end up transferring to Notre Dame College?
Yeah, so when I first moved to the U.S., my first school was actually Lakeland Community College.
Okay.
From there, I spent 3 years there, and the reason for that was because the first year I had a medical, redshirt. I had like some ulnar nerve damage. Honestly, to this day, I still don't even know how that even happened. I swung the bat in the game. And then like, I don't even know, my hand blew up, like it just turned into a size of a balloon. So I was out for quite a while, but then, 2 years went by. And then I actually committed to another school in Pittsburgh, you know, stuff happened over there. And then honestly, if I wanted to keep playing, I had two options left. So I was living out in Painesville at the time, a little bit closer to, Lakeland. So I only had two options. One of them was it Lake Erie? And then the other one was Notre Dame. And it was funny because Notre Dame was never my first option. I actually went on a visit previously, and then I didn't even know. I just saw other schools, and I decided to go elsewhere. But then things happened, so I reached back to the coach. He happily took me on, and then, you know, here I am today, like 5 years later, I'm still here.
Well, that's, you know, always good. You know, I similar thing happened to me when I was in college. An unfortunate injury forced me to the college that I ultimately landed at. I was a swimmer, and, you know, when you blow out a shoulder swimming, that's kind of important to a lot of colleges. They kind of frown upon you having an injured shoulder, but Bethany College ultimately kept their scholarship for me, so ended up there. But you know, now not only you're an alum there, but you're now coaching at NDC. You know, so how did you end up getting into coaching?
So there's a travel ball organization around here called B2 Bulls. I ended up meeting him through a friend, and you know, one thing led to another. I started being an assistant coach for a 13U team because it was one of those things where I need to get my internship done over with. So I decided to go there. Okay. For one, I've coached in the past, but it was just kind of, you know, just here and there. I know baseball. So it was just one of those things where I just kind of see what it was like, but I didn't take it seriously until, probably towards my senior year. That's where I really started to kick it up a notch because, you know, I saw the kids that I was working with. I saw them grow. So the kids that I started coaching at the time, they were 12, 13. Now they're like 16, 17. So, you know, it was one of those things where I kind of watched them grow. And then that's where I started to get more into it. So then as of last year, I actually had my own team. It was an 11U team. Okay. And then now it's 12. Yeah. So now we're just slowly moving up the ranks with them and all that stuff. But no, it was just one of those things where, you know, this game has given me so much. So, you know, I thought it was time to kind of give back. But, you know, I kind of got to that point where all I know is baseball. So there's no better way than for me to kind of stick into the game, really. And that's, you know, again, that's why I moved here. It's mainly because of baseball. So, again, it just kind of got to that point and just kind of fell into my lap a little bit. So now I'm just kind of running with it for as long as I can.
Absolutely. Yeah, hang on to that for as long as you can, man. I mean, I've dabbled a little bit in swim coaching, some summer programs and YMCA programs, but you know, with my schedule being a comedian as well, like, and then adding a coaching schedule on top of that, it's just it was impossible. You know what I mean? To balance all of it, I got way too much going on to be coaching. I would love to be able to coach, but it's not in the cards right now. So your season is actually going to begin like shortly after this episode is going to air. Can you talk to us about what your outlook is for the season and what your team is going to look like this year?
Yeah. So, really excited to get things, going with these guys. So we actually start February 17th. Mm-hmm. So we actually start off, funny enough, we're going to be in Avon, which is our home field. We play at the Lake Erie Crusher Stadium.
Yeah.
So, you know, with the weather that we have here in Ohio, it's very unpredictable. But, you know, regardless of that, we're going to have to get those games. And so, you know, we played in snow multiple times, so it's nothing new to us. But, so we're going to start off our season over there, and then we're going to make our way a few weeks later. We're going to leave from March 1st to the 9th, and we're going to be in Orlando, Florida area.
Yeah.
So we're going to join a tournament over there. It's basically just a bunch of college teams, obviously, who are privileged to be, you know, playing under the sun all year round, just kind of meeting up over there, playing a bunch of games. But so far, we're looking very good. We're looking very good. You know, last year might have been a falling year out for us because the year that I graduated, we probably graduated majority of our starting lineup. So last year, that's where we had a whole bunch of freshmen come into play, obviously with no college experience and whatnot. But, you know, we were in the process of rebuilding, but the coach did a very good job of you know, kind of recruiting what we needed. So now we're pretty stacked on every position right now. And then we also, funny enough, we brought in a new associate head coach. His name's Coach Zach Blair. And, you know, he's really helped us turn things around in this program. So, you know, he's had some pro ball experience and whatnot and multiple years of coaching. He's actually the owner of the travel ball team that I coach for.
Okay.
So he's one of my really good friends, but no, he's kind of, you know, it's fun learning from him. So, you know, with the experience that he's brought and he's kind of, you know, throwing it onto the guys that we have now, I mean, now we're just looking better than ever. So, you know, we're really thankful for him to have him come along and whatnot. But we're looking forward to a good season. I mean, we were ranked fifth in our conference, so it was dead last. But, you know, we already knew that we were going to get ranked last due to our results last year. So, but it's good because, you know, again, we expected it. So we kind of have that, we have that underdog thing. So now we're just going to kind of get after it. And we know what we're expecting, but again, you know, with the coaching and stuff and like, you know, we're just in that rebuilding process. So we're definitely ready to get after it and then, you know, show them what NDC baseball is really all about basically.
Yeah, you guys, I mean, honestly, you know, you're last in the conference. You guys got nothing to lose. Let's go out there and play some ball. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah. Like, that's,
I loved being the underdog in any sport that I ever did. I always loved it when they're like, oh, no way, not going to happen. There's no way you're going to be able to do this in swimming. There's no way you're going to be able to beat this in football, baseball, whatever sport it was. I was like, okay, keep counting me out, please. Keep counting me out. I got nothing to lose at this point in time. I'm just going to go out there and do what I can. And if I win, it's a surprise. If I lose, you are already expecting me to lose, you know? Mm-hmm. So, but you mentioned it there a little earlier in that, but you know, you play at the Lake Erie Crushers stadium. So what is that like for your players and the guys that actually play in that stadium?
Oh God. It's a huge blessing. Although it is 40-minute drive, from our campus. But you know, it's, you know, we're not in the middle of nowhere to tell you that. The other teams in our conference, you know, very good schools, but at the end of the day, you know, they're kind of on the, in the middle of nowhere in West Virginia. So we are blessed to have a little bit of city life to us. And we do play in a very nice stadium where it's all turf. And again, with our unpredictable weather that we have here in Ohio, it's a lot easier to just shovel that snow off and then get the game rolling. So it is very nice. But, you know, the only bad thing is for our hitters, it's hard for the ball to fly out a little bit, but you know, we'll make it work. We hit the ball on the ground, you know, move base runners over, and that's how we'll score our runs. So we'll take advantage of the turf as much as we can. Absolutely. But no, it is very nice to have that, the stadium, honestly, it's so nice.
I mean, you're playing in a minor league stadium, you know, that's a minor league team that plays there. I mean, that's gotta be, you never know if, you know, even for your guys, if, you know, one of the coaches is going to be there, see something that he likes in one of your guys or something like that, that's a huge advantage for your players, you know, going forward.
Oh, yeah,
if they want to go forward in baseball.
Yeah.
So, one of the last things here, and you know, what do you ultimately see your career taking, where you see it taking you as a coach?
Honestly, again, you know, I'm 26, so I like to consider myself, you know, fairly young, but, you know, again, just like the players, I still have a lot to learn about this game, and, you know, each and every day I'm still learning. So, again, the reward I get from coaching, you know, seeing them succeed and all that stuff, I want to stick around for his coaching for as long as I can. But then, you know, 3 years down the line, who knows? I kind of get myself into like a few different jobs here and there. I do baseball analytics for the MLB and such. So I don't know. Who knows really where coaching is going to take me and if I want to, you know, pursue it. But yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard to tell, honestly. But, you know, at the end of the day, my mindset is I am really into coaching right now. So I'm going to ride it for as long as I can and then just kind of see where it takes me. But then, you know, if 2 years from now, a good opportunity with an analytics for another, you know, for a pro team offers me, you know, I'm not going to say no, but I'm not going to say yes either. So it all just kind of depends on, you know, where it's at right now. But I'm really enjoying what I'm doing, you know, as far as like recruiting kids. And, you know, the biggest thing I want right now, especially while I'm here at NDC, is to kind of give them whatever I didn't have here. So that's why we're kind of flipping things around, just, you know, giving them a new look and a new view of the program. Because, you know, especially last year, since we haven't had, like, you know, the best history. So I just want to give the guys, you know, whatever I didn't have and just kind of keep moving forward from there. But, yeah, you know, again, we'll see where coaching takes me. But as of right now, I really am enjoying it. So we'll see.
Yeah, I mean, you're 26, man. I mean, you just made me feel real old. I'm just going to say that right now. I got a son closer to your age than you are to my age. So, yeah, that's fun. But, yeah, I mean, analytics in baseball or coaching, you can't go wrong either way. Yeah. Either way you go in that. So – yeah, best of luck to you on that. I'm definitely – I always follow Notre Dame College sports mainly for Johnny, and we've had a bunch of people on from your guys' institution and everything like that. I always follow them. So we're looking for big things for you guys this spring, and I'm going to be watching you. But I do have to get this segment in here, Kyle, before we end the show, and that is the Fast Fitty Five. Five random questions from the wonderful manager of the podcast, Johnny Fitty Falcone. And for the new listeners out there, this is kind of rapid fire, but you can elaborate if you need to. And I and if anybody knows Johnny, these have nothing to do with what we've been talking about for the past half hour. So if you are ready, Kyle, we'll go ahead and get going.
Yeah, let's roll. All right. I take a deep breath there. Yeah. Let's go. Let's roll.
Question number one. What has been your favorite restaurant you have found to enjoy the most since moving to the U.S.?
Oh, Chipotle, without a doubt.
Okay. Are snowball fights overrated or underrated?
Underrated.
Oh, man. He's bringing the thunder for you on this one. Question number three. Who wins the World Series sooner, the Blue Jays or the Guardians?
You know, I got to go with the Blue Jays.
It's a solid pick. I'm not going to lie to you on that one. Question number four. Is turkey or ham a better food?
Turkey, without a doubt.
Okay. Yep. Last question here. Which is a cooler nickname, the Iceman or Big Thunder?
Oh, Iceman, I guess. Yeah, definitely Iceman.
Iceman, you gotta get it's Top Gun reference. How do you not go with Iceman?
Exactly.
Like,
that
was a toss up for the end one there, I think.
But Big Thunder, it just doesn't flow off the tongue as smoothly as Iceman.
Nah, it really doesn't. No, yeah. I'd rather be the Iceman, you know.
But, yeah, exactly.
For everybody out there, that was the Fast 55. I feel like he took it a little easy on you there, Kyle. You know, you guys worked together, so I feel like he took it a little easy on you, but yeah. Like I said, we are running down near the end of the episode. And, Kyle, I give every guest this opportunity at the end of any show. If there's anything you want to get out there, whether it's, you know, NDC baseball or if it's just a good message from you, I'm going to give you about a minute, and the floor is yours.
Yeah, I mean, I guess, you know, the biggest thing I have to say is, you know, definitely stay tuned for Notre Dame College baseball. I mean, we got a lot of up-and-coming things going our way, and you know there's a lot of positives looking to us. So again, you know, we are the underdogs right now, being ranked fifth. So again, you know, it's definitely going to be a season to watch and look out for, because you know, again, we got a lot of big things coming our way. So we're looking to revamp you know, the whole program right now. So definitely be on the lookout for us.
Absolutely. And like I said, I follow everybody that's been on the show. I will definitely be following you guys this spring and seeing what the team does, and I will be rooting for you every day. But that is going to do it for this week's episode of the Ride Home Rants podcast. I want to thank my guest, Kyle Espineli. I knew I was going to butcher your name once or twice before here. for coming on and taking time out of his busy coaching schedule to talk with us a little bit here about the up-and-coming season and being from Canada. It was a lot of fun. Thank you for coming on. As always, if you enjoyed the show, be a friend, tell a friend. If you didn't, tell them anyways. They might like it just because you didn't. That's going to do it for me, and I will see y'all next week.
The Ride Home Rants podcast is brought to you by Dubby Energy. Energy drinks made for gamers, streamers, and podcasters alike. Go to the link in the description where you can find the best energy drinks out there. Less caffeine than a cup of coffee. Also, no jitters and no crash afterwards. Use the promo code MikeBono and get yourself 10% off. Also, the Ride Home Rants podcast is brought to you by my favorite sponsor of the show, and that is Shankit Golf. Golf apparel made for the everyday golfer. We might not go out and shoot a 6-under par. We're probably going to shoot a 6-over par, but this is going to give us the gear that's going to help us rock it on and off of the course. Go to the link in the bio, use the promo code MikeBono, and get yourself 10% off there as well.